Not only would he take out terrorists, he'd also go after their families. Watch this.
They care more about their families than they care about themselves.
So you're going to assassinate them?
When a wife knows exactly what the husband's going to do, and the husband goes up and he knocks out 200 people with a
bomb, arrest her.
Or he does the kind, I would do pretty severe stuff as far as I'm concerned.
What would that severe stuff be? I mean, and let's not forget, is going after women and children even ethical or effective? We have all-star analysis from Republican strategist Gina Loudon and Democratic strategist Emily Tisch Sussman. Good to have both of you guys here. Gina, starting with you, I mean, he's saying, look, you know, everything's on the table. And we need to be thinking about who's connected to these terrorists that maybe might have known. Is he going further, though? I mean, some have suggested that he's saying he would be violent with them, or do you not see it that way?
This is Trump, classic Trump, throwing the Hail Mary pass, right? He does that, he gets all the headlines, and then he explains what he means. And I think that when it comes down to it, he'll be talking about doing some sensible punishment for conspiracy, which is something that the American public is screaming for, especially in light of the San Bernardino shootings, where there's just no way. Use your brain. That mom knew, and everyone knows that mom knew, and yet, you know, she's claiming she didn't, and the other side is acting like they buy it, which is amazing.
It's kind of hard to imagine how, Emily, she could have possibly lived in the same house with her son and daughter-in-law, where they had pipe bombs, essentially a bomb factory there in the garage, and she didn't know that her son was an extremist, and she didn't know that he was planning some kind of attack. I mean, that does seem like kind of a leap. I spoke earlier with John McCain, and he said, look, we need to be looking at everyone that could be connected with any of these terrorists. Do you agree, Emily?
Sure, and I believe that is happening. I think we all agree that is happening. But look, we have gone beyond trying to be tough and looking at tough rhetoric and being an apologist for what Trump is saying. And look, Cruz was saying some very similar things during that debate. What they're talking about are war crimes. They're talking about bombing civilians. They talk about casualties as if it's a sanitized term. It's killing innocent people. That is not who we are as a country.
Actually, I don't think Donald Trump, and correct me if I'm wrong, Gina, on this, but I don't think he's actually come out and said, I would kill
the mother.
He
certainly didn't say he would kill innocent people.
The sisters.
Right.
You know, he said to Bill O'Reilly, you saw the clip, I'd be looking at doing, you know, some serious stuff, but he hasn't actually come out and said kill. Emily?
So, I mean, I don't think that we need to get that close into semantics to say that this is a really big problem.
No.
But I think it's I think it's a really big problem when the leading contender for president of the United States and one major party is advocating for something that looks even close to war crimes. And no one else is saying anything about it. Everyone's considering it to be tough on terrorism. It's a really big problem.
He is saying that he wants to look at all the people associated, something that, you know, John McCain acknowledged is an important thing to do because you need to be looking at anybody who maybe knew anything. But let's get back
to... doesn't agree with that?
And to be clear, again, he actually hasn't said specifically what he would do, just is suggesting that we should be looking at some of these things. Let's look at what we have seen other countries do, though. For example, Gina, when you look at Israel, Israel will go and plow down the home of a suicide bomber.
Right.
And they will make it extraordinarily difficult for that person to get a work permit to ever work in Israel again. Does it work, though? Because you have groups, right? Aid groups that come along and say, okay, here you go, to the family, and they build them a new home.
Yeah, we have a real problem because within Sharia law, the most assured way to get to heaven is to kill for Allah. And so if for example, with the San Bernardino situation, if the mother knew that that's what her son was planning, it would be, she would perhaps in her mind think she was being a good mother and helping her son get to heaven most assuredly by killing for Allah. So we have a big problem.
So you're getting at is the religion itself, and that fundamentally you got a problem when Islam is advocating for this, or the most extreme version, I should say, of Islam is advocating for this.
Right. I think one of the problems, and you know, my background is in psychology, and I think one of the problems is that we tend to assume Western values on radical jihadists. They don't have Western values. They have a completely different psychological mindset. And so for that mother, she's going to do everything she can.
But she wasn't an extremist. I mean, that we know of.
But if she did believe in jihad, she then absolutely had to believe that if her son did this, he was going to go straight to heaven. It's the ticket. And so that's a problem.
Look, I mean, talk about problem. There's two things to hear that are very big problems, whether they are foreign-born, whether they are U.S.-born. If they are on the terrorist watch list, they can currently buy guns. That is a very big problem.
All right, that's a whole other discussion. We're going to save it for another time. Thank you so much, Gina and Emily. I get some breaking news I got to get to. Breaking this hour, the White House announcing President Obama will...